Tracking sleet and freezing rain, getting ready to move into parts of the state. We are breaking down the timing in the first warm forecast.
The Big Ten investigating after the Badger game turns contentious. Why Michigan's head coach says he hit Wisconsin's assistant coach.
And a Wanakee High School graduate in the fight of his life this morning. How the community is rallying around him and the simple way that you can help.
Good Monday morning, everybody. Welcome to News 3 Now this morning. We're glad you're waking up with us. I'm Leah Lynch-Ide.
And I'm Chris Stanford. Happy Monday. That fight video, it's, nobody wins in that situation. It's
just unbelievable. We're going to break down the video. We're going to hear from both coaches and hear about how this was not the first time Michigan's coach has been involved in an altercation.
It is definitely big news this morning. Also, if there's a bigger story than that, it could be the weather. We have an alert day today and tomorrow. Things could get pretty dicey here, Chris.
And this is not a major storm at all, but it's one that features certain precipitation types that create a little bit more diciness than if this were all snow that we were talking about. Here's what to expect, because things are clear as mud. So I want to paint the picture for you, because you've probably heard that we have some sort of storm coming in. For our folks who live farther to the north, Wautoma, Camp Douglas, back towards Viroqua, this is where you're looking at more of a sleet to snow event. Everywhere else, this is mainly a freezing rain event. Freezing rain to sleet for areas like Watertown, Madison and Mineral Point. Farther to the south, Janesville, Beloit, you're actually looking at rain over to some freezing rain out of this. So we do have winter weather advisories for all of us. It's not a smackdown type of event, but it is going to be disruptive. We are going to see some travel delays. These go into effect later on tonight, and they're going to stick with us throughout all of your Tuesday at this point. So if you're concerned about headed out the door right now, don't be. We're going to be dry throughout your morning commute. We're going to be dry throughout your lunchtime. But it's headed home that our mix starts to begin. And depending on how early you head home, really begins to determine whether or not you're going to see any issues out of this. It's 29 degrees right now, so we are below freezing. Our wind chill at 17. 32 for our friends in Janesville. 25 in the Dells. 32 in Platteville. So most of us hanging out right around the freezing point, and the ground is freezing again, especially as these temperatures begin to drop. We're seeing a couple of flurries right now. Most of the moisture, though, with our northern feature is staying to our north right now. We're going to start to see that increase from the south as we go through time. Check it out. It's now 7 o'clock tonight. You see the pink. Here comes that freezing rain moving in. Check out temperatures. They're mainly into the 20s. Your ground temperatures are going to be frozen as well. Janesville, over towards Milwaukee, you're just above freezing. So this is plain rain for you at this point. I want to push the clock forward even more. We're now at 4 o'clock in the morning. We're all cooling down. Janesville now below freezing at this point. And we are talking about light freezing rain for all of us. When the freezing rain is really light, that is when you're more likely to get the ice adding up. So this is something to keep in mind out there. Now or tomorrow, it's 11 o'clock. We're still dealing with freezing rain and sleet at this point. Given that our ground temperatures are now starting to make it into the teens, I expect more of this to come down as sleet. These colder temperatures should work in our favor to prevent more of that freezing rain, but still we're going to see issues out there. Then tomorrow afternoon and evening, this starts to wrap up perhaps as a little bit of some snow. So that being said, let's start talking amounts. And this is one that it's a little harder to nail down because you really got to figure out how exactly or when exactly things are going to transition. But farther to the north, I'm thinking 1 to 3 inches of snow. For us, a tenth to a quarter inch of freezing rain, less than an inch of the snow and sleet. And then farther towards the south and east, we're talking a glaze to a little over a tenth of an inch of some freezing rain out of that one. Coming up in a few minutes, we're going to talk about how you can be prepared for possible power outages. Those are some of the impacts that you get when you get up to a quarter inch of some freezing rain. But our alert days continue through tomorrow.
All right, Chris Reese, we appreciate it. Thank you very much. You can get the First Warn forecast right at your fingertips with our First Warn weather app. You're going to want it as we track this storm today and into tomorrow. You can download it today in your app store. Just search Channel 3000 Weather. We have some breaking news this morning. Madison police looking for a driver in a hit-and-run crash involving a house on the city's west side.
This happened on Nestling Street near High Point Road and McKee. Around 2:30 overnight, police went to check out what they thought was a car hitting a home. When they got there, though, the driver was gone. Police spoke with the passenger of the car who was uninjured. There was no structural damage done to the house. The officers are still trying to locate the driver. Right now, Badger basketball making headlines this morning for the wrong reasons. The Big Ten now investigating a fight that broke out at the Kohl Center yesterday afternoon.
Yeah, this has become national news. It all started with a conversation between Greg Gard and Michigan head coach Juwan Howard about a late game timeout that Howard thought was disrespectful.
Howard and Gard are not happy right now as the two of them continue to have words. We told you Juwan Howard was not happy about that timeout. Yo! And Juwan Howard just threw a right hand. And now we got a scrum.
Unbelievable. So here's when things got intense. When Howard reached forward and smacked one of UW's assistant coaches, Joe Krabenhoff. Did you see that? In the press conference afterwards, both coaches spoke on the fiasco.
I didn't like the timeout being called, and I'll be totally honest with you. I thought it was, you know, not necessary at that moment, especially being a large lead.
I can take a timeout. That's it gives my players the best chance to have success. So that's where it started, that he said, I'll remember that. And I said, hey, let me tell you why I did what I did. And he didn't want any part of it and kept moving on.
So Michigan's athletic director says he is aware of what happened and will review the situation and work with the Big Ten to determine any next steps. He says he and Michigan's president have reached out to UW to apologize for Howard's behavior. The Big Ten has also been in contact with both schools and is assessing the situation. This, however, is not the first time Howard has been involved in an altercation. Last year, during the Big Ten tournament, he was ejected after arguing with Maryland's bench. That was with 10 minutes left in that game. He was ejected again.
Yeah, we will likely see the fallout, the punishments, and the disciplinary action handed down today. All right, here at 6:06 now, turning tragedy into hope. A Dane County High School is rallying around a former student right now. I took a deeper look at how the community is coming together. He's one of Wanakee's hockey heroes, but Tyler Hoffman could use a win now more than ever. He's been playing college hockey for Purdue Northwest. While home for the holiday, though, a car crash landed him in the emergency room. He's had multiple brain surgeries. Doctors say it could be years before they understand the full impact of his injuries. Now,
this is his hometown. Everybody knows him here.
Tyler's getting an assist from his old high school.
Each ticket is worth $2.
The student council is taking action by selling raffle tickets.
When something like this happens, we all rally, we all come together, and we will hold you up.
Come together, they did. Local businesses donating raffle prizes, signs and stickers supporting Tyler's fight, and schools setting rivalries aside.
Students and parents and even some of the coaches were wearing red, Tyler's favorite color.
It's all for Tyler and his mother.
As a single mom, she's now having to go back to work in order to get the health insurance she needs for Tyler.
Then a phone call.
And I just wanted to tell you that after today, we'll have raised just about $7,000 for you guys.
Oh my goodness, I am beyond words right now.
What these kids have done is just restored a sense of faith and sense of community and coming together and rallying around each other.
Can't wait to give you the biggest hug.
Oh, I would love that.
That raffle is over, but you can still donate to Tyler's family. You can find a link up at channel3000.com this morning or on our mobile app. Just download it for free wherever you get your apps.
Quite an inspiring story this morning to see his community rally behind him. You said Tyler has a long road to recovery.
Yeah, it's going to be a while before they know exactly what he's going to be able to do again later in life. Tyler has a brother in Wanakee High School still in that class that a lot of the student council and a lot of the students who are putting on the raffle, they know this family. Wanakee's not a huge community. I mean, a lot of people know each other, and the community is really stepping up and helping out one of their own who could really use it right now.
No surprise. Big support from a small community.
Love to see it. Well, today is President's Day, and that means there are certain places that will be closed because of that. Most banks are closed today, as well as the Stock Exchange. The U.S. Post Office will not be delivering mail, but FedEx and UPS will. Non-essential government agencies will be closed. That includes the DMV and City Hall. 6 to 9 coming up, NBA All-Star Weekend in the books. So look at how Giannis Antetokounmpo and Chris Middleton did last night.
Back in the 608 this morning with a follow-up to an inspirational story I brought you last year. We're checking in with Coach Kate when we come back.
That was money.
Yeah.
That's a sick bike.
Boys.
Miss Sanderson?
See you Monday.
No way.
Come join the amazing team of compassionate caregivers at the one and only Attic Angel Community. Attic Angel Community of Madison is looking for skilled RNs and CNAs and offers shift differentials and on-demand pay, tuition reimbursement, wellness center, and much more. CNAs starting at $18 an hour. We also offer rewarding careers in housekeeping and food service. Apply online today at atticangel.org. Come join the one and only Attic Angel Community.
Stop whitening your smile the old-fashioned way with strips and trays that can take 30 minutes to an hour. I'm Jonathan Greenhut, the CEO of PowerSwabs. When I met Dr. Gineker and he introduced me to PowerSwabs and I saw how effective they were and how easy they were to use, I knew we had to share it with the world. PowerSwabs was clinically studied to whiten natural teeth as well as stained caps, crowns, and veneers. It's so effective, it works on stains caused by coffee, tea, red wine, and even smoking. For those of you who have that one stained tooth that's darker than the rest, Power Swabs can target that area using swab precision.
I really love the fact that you're able to go individually on each tooth and make sure that it's gonna be wider.
So this Valentine's Day, if you have yellowing between your teeth or coffee stains near your gum line, just snap, swab, and smile. And each 5-minute application, you'll see whiter teeth. So stop whitening your smile the old-fashioned way with strips and trays that can take 30 minutes or an hour and start using the Power Swabs 5-minute solution. Just snap, swab, and smile.
After just 7 days, the results were awesome. Power Swabs was easy to use every day, and each day I could see it better and better, and from beginning to end, it's definitely whiter. They look clean, they feel clean. And people have made comments about it, which is nice.
Call for your 5-minute solution to whiter teeth. So this Valentine's Day, order Power Swabs and receive up to 40% off the retail price. Get a free Power Swabs Quick Stick Pen with your order. The Quick Stick Pen is your on-the-go solution to help prevent stains from adhering to your teeth after drinking coffee, tea, or even after smoking. And in addition to saving up to 40% on your purchase and your free Quick Stick Pen, get free shipping by ordering now. Dial the number on your screen or visit powerswabs.com today.
PB.
PB and J?
PB before we go.
P before we go.
P before we go.
See you tomorrow?
Yeah.
You're watching Madison's fastest growing newscast. News 3 Now this morning.
We're talking about some of the travel impacts that are going to be expected as our upper Midwest winter storm really begins to get going, especially later on tonight and into tomorrow. This morning, headed out the door, no delays, no travel impacts are expected. By your evening commute, though, we're already starting to see some minor delays on the increase, especially as our system starts to get into the mix. Now, this is tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock. We are talking moderate to even some major delays happening across parts of the area as we're tracking freezing rain and sleet through southern Wisconsin. There's a general rule of thumb, and that is don't drive if there is or recently was freezing rain, because it creates a layer of ice on everything. When it's snowing, there's at least traction, and then it's that melting snow that actually creates a little bit of the ice. With freezing rain, there is no traction. It's all ice that you're dealing with at this point, and that's why we're expecting the moderate to major delays as we start to move towards tomorrow morning. But tomorrow afternoon, things begin to subside for us just a little bit, and so our delays begin to go down. But here we are. This is 7:30. 8:30 tonight, our freezing rain starts to move into the picture, and that has time to accumulate overnight. That's why tomorrow morning is going to have more impacts than this evening commute will. This is 11 o'clock on Tuesday. We're still dealing with the freezing rain. Then later on, we could see a couple snow showers and flurries on the backside of that as the system starts to depart into tomorrow. I want to take a moment to talk about amount of snow. Farther to the north, 1 to 3 inches of snow, maybe a little bit more. For us, a tenth to a quarter inch of freezing rain. This is enough to cause power issues, and this is enough to bring down some of those tree limbs. So this is why it is important. Janesville, Beloit, we're talking about a glaze to a little over a tenth of an inch of freezing rain for you. So you get a little bit more rain. That really helps the icing issues for you. But if you're in this purple, this is where your travel impacts are going to be at their worst. And here's some of the things you can do to prepare for that freezing rain. Have that supply of sand on hand along with salt. Charge those devices and gas up the generator just in case of power outages. That food and water is important, along with a car safety kit if you must travel. Speaking of travel, here are the road conditions this morning. They are all good for us right now. We do have one stalled vehicle at Stoughton Road, not causing any delays. This could be all be changing, though, 24 hours from now.
Chris Reese tracking it all for us. We appreciate it, sir. Thank you very much. Quarter after six now, we have a follow-up to an inspirational story we brought you last year here in the 608.
Josh Brider's here with us. He is back from vacation with an update on Coach K. Hey, Josh.
Hey, guys. Good morning. You'll remember we first brought you the story out of Orfordville late last summer on Kate Brown. Coach Kate, as everyone calls her, has helped... Coach Kate, as everyone calls her, has helped run the Parkview School District's wrestling program for 17 years. That includes raising all three of her boys on the mat as well. But her battle of stage 4 lung cancer has been the biggest fight of her life. And she can't thank all of you at home for your prayers and positive encouragement.
You live for not just like wrestling itself, but the family that it is, you know. So we've got a lot of things going on in our program with some families who are going through some hard times right now. And so the way that we support each other and stuff, you know, you just know you always have a backing here. So makes it a lot easier to keep battling through when you know that you've got so many people behind you, you know.
An emotional Coach Kate there. She's making an impact for years, and now she has a lasting legacy as well. She's been inducted into the Coaches Wall of Fame at Parkview School District. It's something her coaching staff says is very well deserved for all of the effort over the years.
Every one of these children calls her Coach Kate or Mom or whatever because they all grew up with her, and her support for the sport and the children and everybody else is amazing. I mean, it's just a true family thing, and she's a family person like that, you know, so it's our wrestling family.
Along with wrapping up the wrestling season, Coach Kate is still crossing off all of those bucket list items, most recently taking a trip to Cancun within the last week with her mom and sister. You'll also remember last summer, Kate was given a prognosis of only a few months, but here she is still crushing it in time and moving forward every single day. Ahead in our next half hour, we're gonna hear from her sons about the lessons they continue to learn from their mom and forever coach, guys.
Well, I'm so happy to hear that she is doing so well right now.
Feeling better now.
It's incredible.
Yeah, you know, she told me she's feeling better now than what she was when we spoke to her about 6 months ago, guys. So there's proof in the pudding right there that some positive attitude, keeping the chin up, is really, really good for a person.
Definitely the inspiration we needed on a Monday morning, right?
Exactly. We'll be thinking of you, Coach Kate. Josh, thank you. Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. Reach out on social media or email him at inthe608@wisctv.com. Automakers are putting electric cars on the fast track. Now they're taking center stage at the oldest and longest running auto show in North America. Charlie DeMar reports.
The atmosphere is charged at this year's Chicago Auto Show, The Buzz, created by more than 12 electric vehicles on display.
New technology, you know, electric vehicles, that kind of stuff. I think it's really important to start doing that kind of stuff for the environment.
And if last week's Super Bowl ads were any indication, car makers are going all in on electric.
The first ever all-electric Chevy Silverado.
People are considering and buying more electric cars
than they used to.
Sales are gaining traction, with EVs expected to make up 4% of U.S. sales in 2022, although gas-powered vehicles still dominate new car sales. U.S. electric vehicle sales reportedly jumped nearly 85% last year, led by industry giant Tesla.
So wherever you live, charge an electric vehicle will be quick and easy.
This month, the Biden administration announced a $5 billion plan to create a nationwide network of EV charging stations over the next 5 years, with the goal of America leading the electric car revolution.
The benefits are enormous. EVs aren't just cheaper to fuel, they are cheaper to own.
And in Illinois, where the nation's largest car show is underway, the state is expected to get $150 million of those electric dollars. Chevy's new Silverado electric truck proudly boasts its American roots.
It's made in Michigan, so we're going to make this at our Detroit Hamtramck Factory Zero facility.
An industry that has constantly evolved and reinvented itself, once again shifting gears. Charlie DeMar, CBS News, Chicago.
To basketball now. $2 appeared in last night's NBA All-Star game. Giannis Antetokounmpo and Chris Middleton. They were actually opponents for this matchup. Giannis was on Team LeBron and Middleton on Team Durant. Team LeBron would go on to win it. Giannis with 30 on the night. Chris Middleton with 5. MVP going to Steph Curry, who made 16 three-pointers and totaled 50 points on the night.
Pretty exciting.
Impressive, yeah.
Yeah.
Coming up, a vacation gone wrong. What priceless item a couple lost and how it was found this weekend. That's coming up in about 4 minutes.
Plus Chris Stanford's own story. Right. Very similar. We'll be right back.
This portion of News 3 Now is brought to you by Shopko Optical.
Cobison Buses, now hiring.
Working with Cobison, it's definitely been great because of the flexibility. If you do need time off, they work around you. They definitely try to make it a company that's based for you.
Visit Cobison.com to apply.
Stretch your dollar with 11% off everything at Menards. Update and beautify your living space with high-quality and unique sliding barn doors from Colonial Elegance. Give your home a rustic look with new doors for any room in the house. With over 20 styles, you can add personality to match your unique decor. Get 11% off all Colonial Elegance doors. Get 11% off everything at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
This is the purpose-built Ford F-150. It's a beast with brains. You know what? Skip this video. Go see one at the auto show.
It's auto show time, the best time to buy a Ford F-150 with ways to power up this and that. Work smarter. Muscle for most anything. Plus, special auto show offers to help you bring one home today. Now get a 2021 F-150 with 0.9% financing for 60 months plus 1,000 auto show bonus cash.
That an apple a day keeps the doctor away. But you still need to see your dentist because getting good dental care is important to your overall health. You know dental bills can take a big bite out of your budget, especially if you're retired or on Medicare. Even a simple cleaning can cost $200. And other procedures like crowns and root canals can cost hundreds, even thousands more. But affordable dental insurance from Physicians Mutual Insurance Company can help. Give us a call or go online for this free information kit with all the details. This isn't just a discount plan. This is real dental insurance that can help pay for over 350 covered procedures like cleanings, fillings, crowns, even dentures. There are no deductibles, no annual maximum, and you can see any dentist you like. So don't wait. Call or go to sendinfokit.com to see how easy it is to save on dental bills.
Physicians Mutual, Physicians Mutual.
At McGann Furniture in Baraboo, we know that hardworking people want the most value for their money. When you shop at McGann, we've already sorted out and selected the brands that we feel offer you the most bang for your buck. From young couples just starting out to senior citizens, we offer a huge selection at prices that will fit your budget. Plus, most purchases include free delivery and setup. And remember, at McGann, we don't raise our prices only to lower them later for a sale. Discover the difference at McGann Furniture in downtown Baraboo.
Cobison Buses, now hiring.
My name's Mike Williams. I've been driving school bus off and on for 21 years. Here at our terminal, we're kind of like a family too. Somebody has an issue with a bus, other people kick in and help and get the job done.
Welcome back. Wanted to give you a peek at my morning this weekend. I was down in Highland for a barbecue chicken fundraiser for the families of the fallen firefighters out of Mineral Point. And some breaking news just into the newsroom. The owner of the Red Zone, where this was hosted in Highland, just texted me that they don't have an official count of all of the dollars raised, but it is upwards of
$20,000. Hey, all right. Wow.
That is double what they were hoping. And no surprise, really. If you were there, you saw the hundreds of folks pick up their chickens through the drive-thru or come in and play in the euchre tournament. Our very own Chris Reese was there. The support for these families was really jaw-dropping, and some of the members of the family were there, and you know, they were brought to tears by all of the stuff that folks had brought for them.
How powerful is that?
Yeah.
You know, the power of community right there coming through. So proud of everyone there in Southwest Wisconsin who stepped up to make this event such a huge success.
And people in Madison also donating. We talked last week about how after we aired the story, a Madison man donated 50 meals. So the firefighters took those meals to other first responders around Southwest Wisconsin and to some nursing homes. So folks who otherwise might not have gotten a meal yesterday did so because of the support here in Madison as well.
How awesome.
Mm-hmm.
How awesome.
Thank you very much to everybody who showed up.
Well, we got to get to this now.
Yes, we do have to talk about this. After losing their engagement ring in the snow out in Colorado, a couple blessed to have it come back to them.
So it's a follow-up story that CBS Denver did. They interviewed a couple who lost a wedding ring. This couple was from Texas, I believe. And then somebody saw the story and then took his metal detector out and found it. There it is. And then they surprised the couple via FaceTime here. And look how happy she is. Could you imagine being without your ring and then finding it?
So you can imagine. Your wife had something similar happen right here in Madison.
Yeah, this is before we moved back to Wisconsin. We were out of state, came back to hang out with some family. We were on Lake Mendota, and my wife lost her wedding ring. And then we had to go back home, and it sat in the bottom of Lake Mendota for a year.
Wow.
Found a ring hunter to take his metal detector, and like, he does this kind of stuff, and wouldn't you know it, we're out in the water for about 90 minutes and he found it.
Miraculous.
Just like that.
These stories blow my mind, that's for sure.
Yeah, she hangs on to that ring just a little bit tighter now. It's wonderful.
All right, Chris Reese, you really don't have a ton of time.
No, but we'll be right back after the break. There's the bus stop forecast. We're cloudy and in the 30s.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Before treating your chronic migraine, 15 or more headache days a month, each lasting 4 hours or more, you're not the only one with questions about Botox. Botox prevents headaches in adults with chronic migraine before they even start, with about 10 minutes of treatment once every 3 months. So ask your doctor if Botox is right for you and if a sample is available.
Effects of Botox may spread hours to weeks after injection, causing serious symptoms. Alert your doctor right away, as difficulty swallowing, speaking, breathing, eye problems, or muscle weakness can be signs of a life-threatening condition. Side effects may include allergic reactions, neck and injection site pain, fatigue, and headache. Don't receive Botox if there's a skin infection. Tell your doctor your medical history, muscle or nerve conditions, and medications, including botulinum toxins, as these may increase the risk of serious side effects.
In a survey, 92% of current users said they wish they talked to their doctor and started Botox sooner. Plus, right now, you may pay $0 for Botox. Ask your doctor about Botox today.
What can Sono Bello do for you? How about a new shape?
Oh my gosh, I'm so happy. I just put this dress on that I haven't worn in over 10 years.
New confidence.
I can see a huge difference. Look at this.
New you.
I can wear a little black dress. I feel sexy.
With Sono Bello, you can remove stubborn body fat permanently in just one visit. Don't wait a moment longer to reveal the new you.
Schedule your free, no-obligation consultation with Sono Bello, America's number one cosmetic surgery specialist, and find out how you can get $250 off. Sono Bello uses Tri-Sculpt micro-laser liposuction to remove your diet-resistant fat cells permanently for incredible transformations in just one visit.
I have one big regret. I didn't go sooner.
Call 1-888-622-8360 or go to sonobello.com.
Always second guessing.
Your senator is working with Donald Trump to take away your right to vote.
That's exactly what Ron Johnson is doing. It's why we must pass the Freedom to Vote Act.
With the Bucks, Alex Lazary took a stand.
Alex Lazary has used his power to expand voting rights.
I'll be a senator about action, not talk. We need to protect voting rights.
What makes him tick is his love and respect for people.
Equity and justice make us stronger. Alex gets it done.
I'm Alex Lazary, and I approve this message.
A winter storm getting ready to move into parts of the upper Midwest. We're breaking down what you can expect in southern Wisconsin.
The sheriff's office revealing Quadrin Wilson did not have a gun when he was shot by police. His family's continued efforts for transparency and answers.
A normal day in the yard gone wrong in Milwaukee. The tragic news from yesterday. Good morning and welcome to News 3 Now this morning, everyone. I'm Chris Stanford.
Happy Monday. Thanks for waking up with us, everybody. I'm Leah Lynchide. The top news of the day, an alert day, two of them actually, in the forecast for some freezing rain headed our way. Chris Reese timing out the impact in his certified most accurate forecast. Hey, Chris.
Yeah, here's what you can expect as we go through Tuesday. Farther to the north and west, we're mainly looking at sleet over to accumulating snow. But if you're in the purple, that includes us right here in Madison. We're looking at freezing rain over to sleet. Meanwhile, farther to the south along the state line over towards Racine and Kenosha counties. This is actually where we're going to see some rain. That rain goes over to a period of some freezing rain before all is said and done. This is not a crippling icing event, but it is enough to be disruptive to travel. And this is why we have winter weather advisories in effect for all of southern Wisconsin. They're starting at 5 o'clock tonight. They're going to go through 6 o'clock tomorrow night. So it's going to be a long duration event here. That being said, as you head out the door tomorrow morning, we're going to be dry. Lunchtime is going to be fine as well, but towards that evening commute, this is when our mix begins and the ground's going to be frozen, folks. So this is where things begin to get slippery for us. Here are temperatures throughout southern Wisconsin already into the 20s, some spots in the low 20s, some spots hanging out right around that freezing point. Janesville at 32, Mineral Point and Platteville at 32 as well. Boscobel just above freezing. That is where you are at 33, but these temperatures are still falling this morning. They haven't started to increase just yet. They'll go down into the 20s. We'll warm up into the mid-30s, but then by the evening, we're back below freezing. So check it out, 7 o'clock. We're at 29 at this point. Here comes that mix moving into the picture. Janesville still at 33, Milwaukee and Kenosha above freezing. This is where things are plain rain. All right, overnight, we all drop below freezing. We're still dealing with freezing rain at this point. Now throughout the day on Tuesday, as temperatures fall into the teens, this is where that freezing rain is going to transition over to a period of sleet where temperatures are a little bit warmer. You're still dealing with freezing rain at that point. We will wrap up as just a little bit of snow tomorrow night. Now we're talking amounts. It's 1 to 3 inches of snow farther to the north and west. For us, a 10 to a quarter inch of freezing rain, less than an inch of sleet. But this is enough that you start to bring damage to the tree limbs. A small tree might come down in weather like this. It's a glaze to just over a tenth of an inch of freezing rain farther to the south and east. You can prepare for it, though. Have that supply of sand and salt for traction. But I really want to encourage folks to charge those devices because power outages are going to be likely, especially if we see some of those higher totals of the ice out there. The bottom line is this, though. Freezing rain is more dangerous than snow, friends, and power outages are going to be possible. That's why I'm stressing charging those devices. This is not a lot. But travel will still be treacherous, and that is why today and tomorrow, mainly tonight and tomorrow, our alert days will track another chance for snow by Thursday.
Okay, all eyes on those alert days. Chris Reese, we know you'll keep tracking it. Thank you. Today and tomorrow, very important days for you to track the weather yourself. You can keep hold of what's going on outside, the freezing rain, the sleet, anything else that might happen, plus the roads, how they're shaping up. It's all over on our Channel 3000 weather app. 6:33 now, a Near East Side family waking up to a stranger sitting on their couch overnight. Breaking news from Madison Police. That man charged with trespassing after officers got a call he'd broken into a house on Willie Street. The caller was so scared she ran out of her house calling police from a park. When officers got there, the woman's granddaughter had already chased the man out of the house. Police found him just down the street. They say he was intoxicated.
The family of Quadrin Wilson, the man hurt in an officer-involved shooting earlier this month, says they're continuing to fight to their fight for justice. They hosted a community barbecue over the weekend as a thank you to those who were offering their support during a difficult situation. Quadrin's brother, Maine Morris, says that his family is devoting their time now to people in the community, giving them a place to speak up.
Not here trying to cover anything up for my brother or nothing. My brother has always been the type to take responsibility for his actions. Life is very valuable, and I think you should spend it with family and friends and be the best you can be.
Morris says he wants the two DCI officers who fired their guns during Quadrin's arrest to face consequences for shooting his brother. On Friday, the Dane County Sheriff's Office said they found no evidence that Wilson had a weapon on him at the time of his arrest. The same day in court, the 38-year-old was charged with felony counts of delivering narcotics.
News 3 Now, your coronavirus headquarters. COVID numbers continue to rapidly decline across Wisconsin. The latest reports from DHS show 1,200 new cases reported within the last 24 hours. The 7-day average now at 1,300. Compare that to the start of the month. That average was right around 5,000 just a couple weeks ago. The rate of positive tests is also at the lowest it's been since October. Now, we are expecting an update from the Madison School District this week on whether it will keep the mask mandate in place past March 1st when Dane County's order is set to expire. Meanwhile, two local groups hosting a virtual forum last night for Madison School Board candidates. The candidates were able to talk about their hopes for the district and the changes they think need to be made to help students readjust after the pandemic. Other districts in our area already have a plan for what they're going to do with masks next month. Belleville, Middleton, Cross Plains, and Wanakee, among them, making masks optional. You can check to see what your child's school is doing. We have a full list on channel3000.com.
Queen Elizabeth has tested positive for COVID. Officials at Buckingham Palace say she is having COVID-like symptoms, but does expect to continue working. Earlier this year, the 95-year-old became the UK's longest reigning monarch. She's believed to have had three vaccines. Her eldest son, Prince Charles, and daughter-in-law, Kamala, Duchess of Cornwall, also recently contracted the virus.
We are waiting to find out who will replace Chief Stephen Davis as Madison's next fire chief. The city's police and fire commission announcing its four finalists. Here they are. They are all current employees within the department. The commission is expected to announce its pick on March 18th. We have a full breakdown of each finalist over on our Channel 3000 mobile app.
New this morning, a tragic accident happening in Milwaukee over the weekend. A man is dead this morning after a tree branch fell on him. Authorities say the homeowner and a crew were doing some yard work yesterday afternoon. They were trying to cut down a tree when one of the branches fell nearly 20 feet and struck and killed the man. Fire officials said that the man had substantial injuries when they got there. Officials have not released his name.
Continuing coverage this morning. Over the weekend, the former state Supreme Court justice leading a review of Wisconsin's 2020 election says he wants to jail Madison's mayor. Last month, Michael Gableman said he didn't want to put Mayor Satya Rhodes Conway behind bars, but in a petition filed in Waukesha County Court Friday, Gableman said she should be jailed for not complying with his subpoenas. Mayor Rhodes Conway told the Wisconsin State Journal that Gableman's investigation has, quote, gone off the rails. Gableman's latest petition also includes the mayor of Green Bay, several city clerks, and the chair of the Wisconsin Elections Commission.
As certain politicians continue to ignore the results of the 2020 election while calling for audits and reviews, the state's chief elections official is continuing to correct false claims. Most recently, Representative Tim Rantham, now running for governor, used the term full forensic physical cyber audits. But Megan Wolf explains, plain and simple, that's not a real thing. Both technically and legally, forensic or cyber audits, the kind you hear for called for again and again, they don't have real meaning in the actual election administration world.
That is not a term that exists in statute. That is not a term that exists as sort of a term of art in election administration. There are terms that do mean a review of an election, but that term is not something that exists in the election or the statutory vocabulary.
On channel3000.com this morning, you can find our full For the Record interview with Wolf. It breaks down what you should know as you sort fact from fiction.
Just into the newsroom, an update out of Highland this morning, where the support from a barbecue chicken fundraiser is blowing expectations out of the water. Dozens of first responders and hundreds of the men and women they serve spent their Sunday hosting that fundraiser for the families of two fallen firefighters from Mineral Point. Highland Fire Chief Kurt James only knew Captain Brian Bush and James Ludlam through work. But in firefighting, professional relationships quickly turn personal.
Sometimes in a small community, a familiar face really means a lot to them. Everybody will see the fire scene or the crash scene, but not everybody sees all the training and the hard work that goes into it.
We just got a text this morning from the owner of the Red Zone, the bar that hosted the event. Gregorius telling us they're still counting, so there's no official number quite yet, but they are close to $20,000 raised. All of that money, every penny, will go back to the families of those firefighters.
What a huge success.
Rousing.
Oh,
very, very proud of my hometown and all of the folks from Southwest Wisconsin and across Wisconsin, really, who stepped up and donated to this effort.
How was the chicken?
The chicken was phenomenal, as you might imagine. If you've ever had park chicken from any of those small towns, they're all great. I might be a little biased. Highlands is the best.
Oh, there's nothing like the taste of that chicken cooked.
Yeah, they had roughly 800.
Like
they added more. They were expecting 700, and they added, I think, like 125 more because they sold out so quickly. They wanted to be able to provide some on site, and it was all gone by the end.
What a success for a great cause.
Couldn't smile harder this morning. So proud.
Okay, it is 6:40. We have some stuff that won't make you smile on the forecast. Yeah, I got some ice, some nasty weather on the way that Chris Reese is tracking. He'll time it out and let you know what to expect.
And it is a follow-up in the 608 this morning. We hear from the sons of a local wrestling coach fighting the biggest battle of her life. The lessons they've learned from Coach Kate. When we come back, stay with us.
Delivery is always fresh because we check our produce at every stop on its journey to you. We're fresh every day, so shop any way. Pick and save. Fresh for everyone.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Who am I?
Wow, is that really me?
Hi, I'm Annette, and I'm an actress. Under-eye bags and wrinkles are so frustrating. They're so hard to hide and so hard to get rid of. I came across Plexiderm, and I was so excited. We have a model. His name is Richie, and all he's doing is taking a small amount. It's so powerful. That's all it takes.
This Valentine's Day, in just 10 minutes, you will look incredible.
This is something that you can do in the convenience of your own home. It's a cream. It's a topical. It literally creates an invisible layer that tightens the skin and smooths it out. All you do is gently rub it underneath your eyes, on your fine lines and wrinkles, and it visibly disappears in as little as 10 minutes.
My real true opinion is holy words I can't say on camera. This is absolutely unbelievable. I mean, I could feel it just lifting my skin. It was amazing. It feels good. It feels great. Looks even better.
I can't even believe that this worked. I was a little skeptical, I am not going to lie, because I saw people online with it. I'm like, yeah, right, that can't possibly work. I'm telling you, it really works.
I thought I might see a little difference, but to see that big of a difference, and you know, I felt something happening, but I had no idea. Like, I have so many dark circles. I have the puffiness, I have the lines. Like, it's amazing. I love it.
I did this to my father at home because I was skeptical. Yes, I admit it. 4 minutes, 34 seconds. The appearance of his under eye bag was completely gone. We were screaming. You have an event. You have any of those moments where you want to feel the best about yourself. I am telling you, the videos that you see on social media and TV are real.
This Valentine's Day is the best time to get Plexiderm for only $14.95 and see it work for yourself after your first application. Your solution is at PlexidermTrial.com or call the number on your screen. At Pick and Save, you can get personalized coupons on top of weekly sales for prices that are lower than low on food that's fresher than fresh. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
U.S. ad spending is set to surpass $300 billion by 2022, and the greater Madison area is poised for major growth. So now would be a great time to consider a career in multimedia sales and to join our team selling our top-rated media and digital solutions. Work for a company that offers training, autonomy, flexibility, income growth, upward mobility, and work-life balance with a competitive wage. If you have a passion to drive results for local businesses, then visit MorganMurphyMedia.com right now to apply.
You're watching Madison's fastest growing newscast. News 3 Now this morning.
Hi, Chris. I'm Marcus from East Madison. Chris, plan my day.
Absolutely, Marcus. I'll tell you what, we've got to get ready for a storm coming into the picture, and hopefully you get to use today to prepare for what's moving in. So tonight into Tuesday, those are going to be alert days that we're talking about, especially for Madison, freezing rain over to some sleet. This is the area that is in the purple. Farther snow to the north and west, more rain as you work your way farther to the south and east. But I want to put things into motion as we plan the day. Most of today is dry. 7 o'clock tonight, you see the clock. Here comes our freezing rain moving into the picture. You still see green farther to the south and east, but we all transition over to freezing rain overnight. And we're still dealing with freezing rain and sleet as we wake up on Tuesday. So this is really going to create that smallest layer of ice on the roadways out there. 11 o'clock, more sleet and freezing rain moving into our picture. This will likely wind down as at least a couple of snowflakes by the time you get you towards the evening on Tuesday. Let's talk amounts. 1 to 3 inches of snow farther to the north and west. We're talking a tenth to a quarter inch of freezing rain for us right around Madison. That quarter inch of freezing rain is enough to start bringing down power lines and those tree limbs or even damage a small tree altogether. So we've really got to be focused on the impacts in this purple zone, and that includes us right here in the Madison Metro. So I want to give you some ways that you can prepare. Consider having the things to add traction. That's that supply of sand and salt. But also, if we were to lose power, keep those devices charged and maybe add some gas to that generator just to make sure you're set to go. To avoid travel, though, have that food and water on hand at the house ready.
Chris Reese with all that advice this morning. We appreciate it. Thank you, sir. According to 7 Now, we have a follow-up to an inspirational story we first brought you last year in the 608.
Josh Brider is here with us with an update on Coach Kate. Hey, Josh.
Hey, guys. Good morning. Coach Kate, as everyone calls her, has helped run the Parkview School District's wrestling program for 17 years. That includes raising all three of her boys on the mat. But her battle of stage 4 lung cancer has been the biggest battle of her life. Last summer, Kate was given a prognosis of only a few months, but she's still not giving up hope. The family is so thankful for the community supporting them every step of the way. And the proudest of them all are her three boys, who will always look up to their mom for her strengths.
It's hard to feel like she's sick because of how positive she stays and how active she is. You don't see it, even though you know it. It's just kind of a great part about her is that she's not gonna show it. She's not gonna ask for a pity party. She's just gonna keep going with her life and like nothing's happening.
I have to keep your mind off everything, you know? Like, keep going, keep working for something. And there's always something to do and get done. There's always goals to, you know, pursue.
You want a double leg him?
Such a great family there, and wrestling is a family thing for Kate, both getting to coach her boys growing up and now getting to coach alongside them as well, which makes this moment right here all the more special. Coach Kate was inducted into the Coach's Wall of Fame at Parkview Schools. It's something she's especially proud of.
Sometimes, you know, you can give a lot of your life to something and it doesn't chalk up to much, but I think this did, so. For all of us, so me and my kids are up here still coaching, and John Rice got me started, and that was 17 years ago. You know, I thought he was crazy when he asked me to start, and I never knew I would still be here this long later, or that it would be such a big part of our lives. But we're up here every day, so something I do with my boys.
Along with wrapping up the wrestling season, Coach Kate is still crossing off all of those bucket list items. She just got back from a trip to Cancun with her mom and sister. It was the first time that they had been out of the country. So crossing off those bucket list items for sure. Her oldest son, Byron, who you just heard from in this piece, is also getting married this spring as well. So she's going to keep that positive attitude and prayers going, as the whole family says it's keeping them in good spirits. They're asking all of you at home to keep the prayers alive as well, guys.
Boy, she looks great, John. She feeling okay?
Yeah, she's telling me that she is feeling better now than what she was when I spoke to her last time around 6 months ago, guys. So
that's
there you
incredible.
Go. Yeah. Positive attitude. It makes a world of difference.
She's got an awesome community to hold her up to.
Exactly. Quite the inspirational story on a Monday. Josh, thanks for sharing that update.
Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. Reach out on social media or email them in the 608 at WISCTV.com. All right. 6:48 coming up in the morning sprint, all the morning's top headlines. And we also want to say happy birthday before we go to break to Elise, Sarah, and Avery. And all those kiddos turning three today. Thanks for celebrating with us. We'll be right back.
Look Who's Three is sponsored by Three Bears Resort, indoor water park and conference center in Warrens, Wisconsin.
It's Make My Mondays at Hy-Vee. This Monday, get Pepsi six-packs for just $1.48. That's right, get six-pack bottles of Pepsi products for just $1.48. Monday only. Scan the QR code or check out HyVeeDeals.com for more deals.
I grew up working in my family's supper clubs. This is where it started with us as far as the fish that we serve at Culver's today. We source the finest cod and batter each fillet by hand and always cook it to order. That beautiful golden brown color and flaky on the inside. The fish fry is a Midwest tradition. It's about families coming together. I love bringing this tradition to guests everywhere. Mom and Dad would be proud. Welcome to Delicious.
Everyone deserves stylish and quality furniture. So I'm calling all Bobs to help get the word out. Like this Bob, the original Bob.
Hi, I'm Bob, the Bob. President's Day weekend is here and I'm celebrating big time with free treats in all my cafes. Plus untouchable values on living rooms, dining rooms, bedrooms, and my world famous Bob-O-Pedic mattresses. And if you love value as much as I do, stop by your local Bob's Discount Furniture Store to get your free honorary Bob pin.
Come celebrate all President's Day weekend long.
Did you know you can switch to a five-star United Healthcare Medicare Advantage plan today? Hi, I'm Joanne Fisher, your local sales director in southern Wisconsin. The Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services has awarded a United Healthcare Medicare Advantage plan in southern Wisconsin 5 out of 5 stars for quality and service. If your current Medicare plan isn't meeting your needs, you can switch to a 5-star United Healthcare Medicare Advantage plan in southern Wisconsin today. Call 1-800-861-5410.
Dear Winter, I'm coming. My squad of 16 vehicles with all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive is ready to take you on. Safety is the name of my game, so you better bundle up. Toyota. Right now, you can get 2.49% APR for 60 months on Toyota's most popular 2022 models. Find yours at Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Grass looks great, Zeus. Hey, could you maybe trim the hydrangea too?
Sure thing, Kevin. You want me to do the box switch as well?
No.
Finding the right person for the job isn't always easy. But when you have an insurance question, you can always count on your local GEICO agent. They can give you personalized advice and could help you save hundreds.
Hey, Medusa, let's boogie.
For expert help with all your insurance needs, get to know your local GEICO agent today.
It's Make My Mondays at Hy-Vee. This Monday, get Pepsi six-packs for just $1.48. That's right, get six-pack bottles of Pepsi products for just $1.48. Monday only. Scan the QR code or check out HyVeeDeals.com for more deals.
Contact Gingrass Thompson & Walks for a free consultation.
6:52, time for the morning sprint.
The Big Ten now investigating the fight that broke out at the Kohl Center yesterday afternoon. The Badgers ended up winning against the Michigan Wolverines, but this fight broke out when Greg Gard was talking with Michigan head coach Juwan Howard about a late game timeout that Howard thought was disrespectful. Watch this. This got really heated when Howard reached out and hit one of UW's assistant coaches. There it is. More from Coach Gard and the ensuing investigation, along with what Coach Howard had to say. That's all up on channel3000.com.
A neighborhood on the east side back open this morning after a severe gas leak. It happened on Egan Road near the Princeton Club. Officials had to shut off gas for the one block radius Saturday afternoon after a homeless man notified firefighters of a gas smell. Crews spent Sunday morning opening doors and windows so the buildings could ventilate. They say it could have been much worse if they'd not been alerted.
Russian troops now receiving orders to proceed with an invasion of Ukraine. That's according to new U.S. intelligence this morning. Russia is also rescinding a pledge to pull tens of thousands of troops back from Ukraine's border, extending military exercises in Belarus that were slated to end yesterday. President Biden held an emergency meeting with his national security team on Sunday and consulted with French President Emmanuel Macron in a phone call.
Well, police in Wausau say that they responded to more than 170 car crashes during Friday's nasty weather. Police were arriving and finding more vehicles crashing and then piling up into the median. Wausau police got help from the city's fire department and state patrol. At least 10 people were hurt.
A lost pup is heading home this morning. Beloit police say they found this guy, Victor, wandering by himself Saturday. They tried to identify his owner through his rabies tag, but luckily he was microchipped, so they were able to contact his family. Police say Victor is safe and sound, but he might be in some trouble with his parents.
Hey, it's almost Girl Scout cookie season. The Madison Leadership Center getting a little jump start here. They hosted an event to get the girls psyched about the iconic program, which begins on the 5th. The girls learned several skills, including money management, business ethics, and goal setting. Hey, there's a new cookie this year, too. If you haven't heard, the Adventurefuls. It's a brownie-inspired cookie with a caramel-flavored cream.
We're waiting to find out who will replace Chief Stephen Davis as Madison's next fire chief. The city's police and fire commission announcing its four finalists on Friday. All four are current employees in the department. That interview process will include a recorded 15-minute community presentation. All of those will be shared with the public by March 10th. The commission expected to announce its pick on March 18th.
This morning, Australia is back open. For the first time in 2 years, borders opened up and planes are headed in. Anyone who has been vaccinated is now able to enter the country.
New research finds treating babies with antibiotics in the first week of life is linked with a decrease in healthy bacteria that helps digest breast milk and promotes gut health. The study, published in Nature Communications, also found an increase in antimicrobial resistance.
Many Americans are just one hospital visit or car problem away from onerous credit card debt. According to Bankrate, only 53% of adults have more money in an emergency savings account than on a credit card. What's more, 22% of U.S. households have more credit card debt than rainy day savings. On the bright side, the figures are an improvement from a year ago.
Carnival Cruises will be relaxing its mask rules next month. Beginning March 1st, masks will not be recommended. Will not be required, but recommended instead. The company says there may be certain venues and events where you will have to wear a mask. The Carnival Corporation owns several major cruise lines. According to the company, 13 million passengers sail on board a Carnival-owned ship in a typical year.
Alert Day's in the picture tonight through Tuesday. We're going to be talking a little bit of everything, so here's who sees what. For everyone in the purple, we're talking more so freezing rain and sleet. It's snow to the north, rain to freezing rain, a little bit farther to the south, and that starts overnight tonight. This is 7 o'clock. Here comes the freezing rain moving into the picture. We're going to keep this around throughout all of Tuesday before things end as just a little bit of snow. In Madison, we're talking a 10 to a quarter inch of freezing rain, less than an inch of the snow and sleet.
Keep it right here to News 3 Now, folks. We're going to continue to track that alert day all day long.